Hello world, my name is Oleksandr, and I work on Fluent UI React at Microsoft Development Center Prague. In the previous episode, we talked about common issues and problems with CSS. I suggest check it out if you haven't yet, for more context. In this episode, I'm not talking about problems anymore. It's time to talk about the solution. And we have it. It's called Griffel. We were looking for serious performance improvements in Fluent UI React V9. Optimizing the styling query contributes significantly to that goal. We needed to change something in our approach. So, should we take a step back and get rid of CSS-in-JS completely? It's something that we prototyped, but the result was not surprising. We ran into the same CSS specificity issues that I talked about earlier. We started to collect requirements for a solution that would satisfy both our goals and those of our customers. We don't want to deal with CSS specificity issues, so our solution will rely on Atomic CSS. We should have theming support. In initial discussions, AE11 was still supported, so our solution should have theming capabilities. But during implementation of Fluent UI React V9, AE11 was deprecated. This requirement was changed, and we could rely on CSS variables for theming. Use classes for styling. We built our styling wrapper around Fellow.js in Stardust UI. The wrapper produces classes and styles objects. Based on the type of the rendered component, the developer needs to decide whether to pass classes string or the styles object to the underlying component. An intrinsic element only accepts classes. Stardust component performs style merging. For that reason, it must be passed the style object. Why style merging is so important? As we use Fellow.js and Atomic CSS in Stardust UI, we need to avoid duplicated definitions for CSS properties. Otherwise, results will be non-deterministic. The only way to do this with Fellow.js is to merge styles before they are passed to Fellow itself. That's why we need objects with styles in Stardust components. Does it sound complex already? In Stardust, we have a similar slot model as in Fluent UI React V9. And sometimes we pass additional styles to slots. A component in a slot can be either an intrinsic element like a div or a Stardust component. This is the customer's usage, because they can choose to use components as overrides for slots. But from the library perspective, we don't know when to pass classes and when to pass style objects. That's why we have this requirement. The problem is solved if we use only classes. Minimal runtime cost for performance. We have smart styling libraries, and they do a lot of good work. The problem is that they do it at runtime, and our customers are the ones who pay performance penalties for it. Before I continue, let's summarize existing options. We have static CSS, it's fast, but cannot be used because of CSS specificity issues. CSS-in-JS solves specificity issues, but at a price of high runtime performance cost. What if we could combine benefits of both? Use CSS-in-JS, but minimize runtime cost by doing the most expensive work at build time. One of my colleagues shared the presentation about stylings. The approach described in their presentation was exactly what we wanted to have. Our first reaction was, let's just use it, but unfortunately it wasn't open sourced. However, the idea of CSS extraction and a simple approach for merging classes blew our minds. It all perfectly fit into our requirements. To be clear, our goal was not to create a new library. I would personally prefer to use an existing one instead of maintaining one more piece of our foundation. I mentioned stylings and their approach to CSS-in-JS. Let me explain the important concepts behind it. we decided to use Atomic CSS as a solution for CSS specificity issues. Atomic CSS defines a new class for every combination of CSS property and its value. Therefore, we can consider classes as the mapping to CSS properties and values combinations. Now, let me explain why these mappings with four JavaScript objects are so useful. First, since classes mappings are represented as four JavaScript objects, merging of different styles can be done by merging these objects, and it's relatively cheap at runtime. Second, it's easy to obtain classes from it. Just take the object values and concatenate them. Your string with classes is ready and can be applied to an element. Why is class merging so important? To avoid multiple definitions for the same property on a single element. After merging, classes are deduplicated. This is one of the basic ideas behind Atomic CSS. One of the problems that comes with Atomic CSS is that we need to respect the LVFHA order. Do you know about it? It looks like I can't stop talking about CSS specificity issues, but it's the last time. No, it's not. Several classes in CSS like hover, focus, active, and link have equal specificity, and the result is determined by order of appearance. Doesn't sound like a problem yet? When we insert atomic classes to DOM, we insert them based on order of rendering reg components, basically based on usage. This means our resulting styles would be based on which component styles were rendered first. Welcome to random button behavior. Doesn't sound fun anymore. One of the options was to insert CSS rules in a specific order, but it would be too expensive. It also has value complexity. The more CSS rules there are, the more expensive it is to process it. Instead of trying to enforce the order of CSS rules, we decided to insert these rules into separate style elements. We call these elements style buckets. From a performance perspective, it doesn't matter on which style element we will call insert rule method. It became a nice solution. These style buckets follow LVFHA order. Since this order is stable, our styles will be deterministic. The same approach is used in compiled CSS, and we took this idea from that library. Fluent.js uses a similar approach to order media queries deterministically. I also would like to mention how we decided to generate CSS classes. Fluent.js, for example, uses an incremental approach, where the first class name is A, second is B, and so on. This approach is nice because it reduces the bundle size price for CSS, since CSS rules will contain fewer characters. Another option was to use full properties and values. This looks nice for debugging purposes, but it's painful for bundle size. These approaches are opposite to each other. We found a middle ground by using hashed classes based on the CSS property and value of a rule itself. The hashing algorithm is deterministic and doesn't depend on the environment. This means that hashes will be the same regardless of where they were generated, during application build, on a client, or by server-side rendering. It's a good moment to end with something optimistic, but there is another problem that is related to CSS shorthands. With Atomic CSS, we don't get the same deterministic result. This snippet renders the expected results only when we render the second styles. If we will render the first styles prior to that, it will break. As we have already learned, the order of appearance matters for CSS rules. There are different approaches to solve this problem. For example, Atomic Engine for StyleTron, StyleTron is another CSS-in-JS library, warns once longhand and shorthand properties appear in the same style rule. Well, this approach will not scale, as everyone ignores warnings. Fluent.js has expand shorthand plugin to expand properties and merge them. While most shorthands are in fact easy to expand, for example margin and padding, the more complex like background are not. In order to support all properties, a lot of magic needs to be implemented. This adds huge runtime overhead and in the end doesn't work in 100% cases. For example, you cannot expand CSS variables without knowing the current value of it. In Griffel, we don't use shorthand properties at all. Doing that, we eliminate the problem. The result is deterministic. Engineers need to explicitly handle shorthands, but we help with shorthand functions that perform expansion with explicit arguments. With deterministic classes and atomic CSS, we have possibility to perform CSS extraction. We don't use CSS rules themselves, and thanks to object class mapping, we know all the classes before runtime. This means that we can extract rules to CSS stylesheets and remove them from JavaScript files. Unfortunately, this process is not so easy because of the previously mentioned LVFHA order. We need to follow the order in CSS files across different chunks too. That's how Griffel appeared, a CSS-in-JS engine that is a core part of Fluent UI React v9. By default, it works only at runtime. This allows partners just install npm package and get it running. No webpack configs, etc. Like any CSS-in-JS library out there. Now we have a reasonable ask. Our requirement is to have minimal runtime work. How we can solve this problem? We created a Babel plugin and a webpack loader that perform all CSS transforms during build time. The only work left at runtime is styles insertion to DOM. Class merging is also work that needs to be done at runtime. But in terms of performance, it's not very useful metric, as even plain CSS needs something like class names package to concatenate classes. You would think that implementing Griffel would be a hard and complex process, but it turned out to be more straightforward than we thought. We had experience with our own merge styles library and other CSS-in-JS engines. While Griffel is a custom solution, it still reuses a lot from existing open source libraries. Griffel is a cocktail of different approaches and ideas. We have generated classes using a motions function. Style resolution is heavily inspired by Fava. The API for class merging is inspired by compiled CSS. We simply made our own implementation with a different approach. For the Babel plugin, we use module evaluation from Linaria. It would be really hard to build Griffel without these libraries. Our goal is to contribute back to the community via issues and pull requests. And that's what we are already doing. After we collected all our requirements and ideas, we just iterated until the final solution. There was a lot of dogfooding during the implementation of Fluent UI React v9. The final API is miles away from the initial implementation. For example, we dropped A11 support so we could rely on CSS variables for theming. We stopped trying to expand CSS shorthands. And we even changed how class merging works. From the story, it sounds like everything went smoothly. But that's only partially true. We rely on atomic CSS, and it has some limitations to be deterministic. In one of our IRCs, we agreed to stop expanding CSS shorthands. Because we are not the browser, and we don't have enough information to do this properly during build time. As we don't expand CSS shorthands, their usage is prohibited. Pseudo-selectors are also inserted in a defined order, to make the result deterministic. The same approach is used for media queries and other attributes. These small problems contribute to the bigger issue, the complexity of CSS extraction process. It's fair to say that it's easy to extract CSS. The process is known. It could be implemented in a webpack loader, and it will work, until you configure code splitting with webpack. Because the order of CSS rules should be preserved between chunks that contain different CSS files. Well, but who said that this issue cannot be solved? Griffel was born as a part of Fluent UI React v9, but now it's a separate open source project. So feel free to try it either as a part of Fluent UI or separately in your project. See you next time. Atomic CSS. There was a lot of dogfooding during initial implementation of Fluent UI React. During the implementation,
during the implementation,